Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube videos. In the previous video of this playlist, I told you about the central limit theorem. Now, in this video, I'm going to give you one interesting application of the central limit theorem, and we are going to see how we can use this result to prove Stirling formula. So, I remind you that Stirling formula is a well-known formula in mathematics that gives you some kind of asymptotic behavior of n factorial when n is large. And so, more precisely, that says that n factorial behaves like square root of 2 pi n times n over e at the power n. Behaves like, here in this expression, means basically that the left-hand side divided by the right-hand side converges to 1 as n goes to infinity. So to solve the problem, we let xi be a sequence of independent Poisson random variables with the same mean mu equals 1. As usual, in the context of the central limit theorem or strong law of large number, we call Sn the sum of the first n of those random variables, x1 plus x2 up to xn. The first question is to use the central limit theorem to prove that square root of 2 pi n times the probability that Sn equals n converges to 1 as n goes to infinity. So I rewrote this statement here. We need to prove this. Our assumption is, again, Sn is the sum of the first n. Those xi are independent Poisson random variables with parameter 1. So we are exactly in the context where we can indeed apply the central limit theorem, because those random variables are identically distributed and also they are independent. So the central limit theorem tells us, so CLT for central limit theorem implies that, well, Sn minus its mean, so the expected value of those random variables is 1, so that means that the expected value of Sn is equal to n, so this minus n divided by square root of n, and we need here also a sigma that corresponds to like where sigma square is going to be the variance of those random variables, but Poisson, the Poisson random variable with parameter 1 as variance equal to 1. So that's the term that we need to, that this term is going to converge to a normal random variable with parameter 0, 1 according to the central limit theorem. The sigma here is equal to 1. And so eventually we have convergence in distribution to the normal random variable with parameter 0 and 1. Okay, so that's what follows from the central limit theorem. Now, how can we deduce this limit here? I'm going to start with this quantity, so probably that Sn equals n. Here in this case, so there is a little trick here. Sn is a discrete random variable, but in the limit here, we have a continuous random variable, so to be able to compute our limit and have some integral, I'm just going to rewrite this as the probability that Sn is, let's say, between n and n plus 1. So to switch from discrete to continuous, so this is equal to the probability that, let's say, n is less or equal to Sn, Sn strictly less than n plus 1, let's say. So now that we have this expression, you see that if I subtract n here, I get this term, and then I'm going to also divide by square root of n, and so that tells us that this expression is also equal to the probability. So we have an n minus n over square root of n is just 0, less or equal to Sn minus n over square root of n, Sn minus n over square root of n, strictly less than n plus 1 minus n is 1 divided by square root of n, so 1 over square root of n. Okay, and the convergence here in the central limit theorem, the convergence to the normal random variable with mean 0 variance 1, tells us that this probability asymptotically when n is large is like behaves like the integral from 0 to 1 over square root of n of the density function of this random variable. So that behaves like integral from 0 to 1 over square root of n. So the density function of this random variable is 1 over square root of 2 pi e to the minus t square over 2 dt. Now, here you see again that when n is large, then the domain of integration here, the interval goes to 0, okay, it's very, very small. And so eventually, asymptotically, when n is large, this integral is going to converge to just when the value of the density function, when t is basically equal to 0, okay, between 0 and 1 over square root of n, that's basically t is going to converge, is going to be very close to 0. So this part here is just equal to 1. And so this part is 1. And then eventually your integral is just equal to the length of the interval of integration, 1 over square root of n, times the value of the density function at 0, that's just 1 divided by square root of 2 pi. So eventually, you see that, okay, I'm going to erase this part. Remember, this part we just said is of the order when n is large of 1 over square root of 2 pi n, okay? So 1 over square root of 2 pi n. And so, indeed, this shows this result, okay? The fact that, like what I wrote here, probably that Sn equals n behaves like this term means exactly that this divided by that, so that means indeed this term is going to converge to 1 when n goes to infinity. Now, second and last question, deduce Stirling's formula from the previous question. So I rewrote here Stirling formula so that we have this in mind. So you see that we need here we have a square root of 2 pi n that appears here and here. And here this is like it seems that the last step to indeed deduce Stirling formula is to write this probability here more explicitly. So and for that, the only thing we need to do is to really understand this random variable Sn better. So if you look at Sn, that's a sum of n independent Poisson random variable with parameter 1. That's, it turns out that this random variable is Poisson distributed, again, with parameter n. So I remind you that if you have a sum of independent, independence is important, if you have a sum of independent Poisson random variable with parameter, let's say mu1, mu2, up to mu n, then the result is again a Poisson random variable with parameter the sum mu1 plus mu2 and so on up to mu n. Here, all the mu I are equal to 1. So Sn, in fact, I can write it here. Sn is the Poisson random variable with parameter n. So this is Poisson with parameter n. And so using the expression of the probability mass function of this random variable, we can write this probability more explicitly and then eventually deduce the result. So what we know from the first question is the behavior of this. So I'm going to rewrite that square root of 2 pi n times the probability that Sn equals n. So this, because we have a Poisson random variable, so I remind you also that probability that a Poisson with parameter mu is equal to k is going to be mu at the power k divided by k factorial times e to the minus mu. Here we are in the case where both mu and k are equal to n. If you just replace in the expression, you are going to get, so you still have this square root of 2 pi n, but times you need some parameter n at the power n again, divided by n factorial times e to the minus the parameter, it's n again. So we have this expression, okay? This is exactly equal to that. Now we know from the previous question that the limit here is 1. Okay, so that shows that indeed this expression here that we recognize here divided by square root of n converges to 1, and so that indeed this statement is indeed equivalent to the fact that n factorial behaves when n is large as square root of 2 pi n times n over e at the power n.